everyone, it's me Harshita, and welcome back to another awesome Friday with me. So just a quick disclaimer, I won't be talking any Telugu today, I'll only be speaking in English because this video is mostly helpful for high school students living in America compared to India. And yeah, without any further ado, let's begin the video. Video, I'll be explaining you guys what Running Start is, how you can do Running Start, and how you know if you're eligible for Running Start. And I'll also be talking about the associate's degree program and how you can finish it too. So yeah. So to begin with, Running Start is a program that's only available in very few states like Washington, New Hampshire, Montana, Illinois, and Hawaii. So it's very limited, but definitely a recommended course. If you're from any of these states, I definitely recommend you to take this program because it's definitely helpful, and I'll never ever regret this decision I took. So basically, Running Start is a program where it allows 11th grade students and 12th grade students to take college courses at any community college near their location. So this way, students earn both high school credits and college credits at the same time. So you basically need to fulfill your high school graduation requirements and your college requirements. This sounds pretty stressful, but trust me, it's definitely not. So basically, your high school pays all the money you need for your college. So it pays for 2 years of college at your community college. So your high school gives you a 15 credit limit each quarter. So each quarter at your community college, you only need to take classes that are equivalent to 15 credits, which is approximately 3 classes a quarter. So instead of taking 7 classes each year or each semester, you only need to take 3 classes. It sounds pretty light. So you don't have a lot of work to do. You only have, and you could schedule it however you like it. So I take my classes in the afternoon compared to in the morning because I can't wake up super early in the morning. So you can choose when you want to take your classes. You can manage your time all by yourself. You can basically control your schedule and everything. So if you exceed the 15 credit limit though, you need to pay all the tuition fee. If you take classes that are above 15 credits, so if you go to 16 or 17 credits, then you need to pay all the money. So technically, each course at Running Start is only 5 credits. So for example, if I need to finish my 11th grade English, which is 1 year of English at high school, I only need to take it 1 quarter. So I'm taking English 101 at my community college, which is just 5 credits. So every 5 credits counts as 1 full year at your high school. So basically in like 2 quarters, you can finish all your high school requirements, and then the rest of the quarters, you can take whatever you want. And yeah, Running Start is pretty simple. You just don't need to take every course like an year long. You just need to take it per quarter. So if you need more information on this, please contact your high school counselor, because every school is different, and yeah, talking to your counselor definitely helps. So first, in order to apply to Running Start, make sure you go to your counselor and know if you're eligible or not. You at least need to have like a 3.0 or a 2.0 GPA in order to be a Running Start student. And you also need to know that you should be able to handle a lot of stressful time, and you need to have a lot of time management and everything, because you need to finish clubs and sports or other stuff at your high school. At the same time, you also need to finish your homework and classwork courses at your Running Start, like your community college. And like, usually lectures in community colleges are so long and they could be stressful at times, but trust me, professors are super nice. They give us a lot of extra credit opportunities, and we also have very limited work compared to high school. So yeah, you need to manage all those things. So talking to your counselor is definitely super helpful while applying. You need to talk to your counselor when you're basically at the end of your sophomore year. So by junior year, by the beginning of junior year, you would start going to your community college. So you cannot go to your high school anymore for taking classes. You could still do clubs or sports at your high school, but you cannot take any courses at your high school. You should be only taking courses at any community college in your place. Now that's Running Start, let's talk about the associate's degree program, which is also known as the AA degree program. So the associate's degree basically gives you a guarantee that you have finished 2 years of your bachelor's, and you need to do the other 2 years at any university if you want to. So you could just do the associate's degree and just, you're good to go. You can go and work, but it wouldn't be as effective as taking the bachelor's degree too. So basically, when you just do Running Start, it won't give you a guarantee that you will be taking only 2 extra years at university. It could depend, like you could take, you can take approximately like 2 to 3 years at university, but when you take the associate's degree, it literally shows you that you have finished 2 years of your bachelor's and you only have 2 more years remaining. So yeah, I'm taking the associate's course. You just need to take 2 extra courses for that, and it's very simple, like approximately like 2 to 3 extra classes at your community college, and it definitely helps you stay more organized, I would say, because it's not a lot of work. It's just 2 extra classes, and you will have a lot of time in your Running Start program, so you could fit these 2 to 3 classes at any time. And yeah, I definitely recommend you to take the AA degree program. You sign up for the AA degree when you like first do Running Start. You talk to the college advisor instead of your high school counselor. So now you need to go talk to your college advisor and ask them to explain what the AA degree is, and ask them if you're eligible or not again, because it also needs some kind of like terms and things. So yeah, anytime before you take a decision, go talk to your parents, counselors, and advisors. These people are super helpful to make a decision. And yeah. So yeah, Running Start does sound pretty stressful and everything, but once you start the process and everything, it goes pretty easy, and yeah, you just don't have to worry as much. But to conclude all this up, Running Start is basically a dual enrollment program that allows a student to take college level courses at any community college near their area. And this way you can save a lot of time and money, because your high school basically pays for your college. And if you're from any of these 5 states I told you, make sure you go to your high school counselor and talk to them and make a good decision. I definitely do not regret this decision I took. I'm loving this course, and I hope you do too. So yeah, that's it for this week's video, guys. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section below. I'll definitely try to answer them as much as I can. And yeah, see you all next Friday with some amazing content. Bye!